In Afghanistan, most girls are not allowed to play sports, and most sports activities just for boys. Yet, skateboarding is the largest sport for girls in Afghanistan. And Mazar-e Sharif, a city in northern Afghanistan, has the highest concentration of female skateboarders anywhere in the world. How is that even possible? It's possible through the incredible friendships that can be forged through skateboarding. And this story starts on the bumpy and polluted streets of Kabul, a city that's hardly ideal to skateboard in. I went to Kabul in February 2007 when my girlfriend got a job there and I was also looking for a research job. I had no idea what to expect going into a war zone for the first time. And as the plane got closer to Kabul, I was actually scared, and I even told myself somewhat overdramatically, I'm ready to die. I brought my skateboard with me to Afghanistan, as I have today. I bring my skateboard most places that I go because it's a great way to, well, it's fun, and it's a great way to meet people across different cultures. And when I went into the streets of Kabul, everywhere I went, people were friendly to me. Policemen invited me around for dinner. Carpenters offered me cups of tea. I'd never been in such a hospitable place in my whole life. Later, I found out that Afghans make these invitations as a matter of custom, and they have to actually ask you three times before they really mean it. That explains the bewildered looks on the faces of the carpenters as I sat down in their workshop with them for a cup of green tea. There's not many foreigners on the streets of Kabul. They're either armed to the hilt or traveling around in armored vehicles with bulletproof glass. And there's lots of money flowing into Afghanistan. A few trillion dollars spent by the international community since 2001. But money doesn't work in Afghanistan the same as it can work in other countries. I had a hunch that it was trust that was missing between the people that were doing these transactions. Afghans didn't trust foreigners. Foreigners didn't trust Afghans. The different Afghan ethnicities didn't trust each other. But after so many decades of war, it's not really surprising that there were such low levels of trust in society. So I started a search for how trust could be found, and I started that search on my skateboard, of course. I put the skateboard down and I pushed off. In the streets, skateboarding in the streets, kids would circle around me, and a foreigner on the streets of Kabul is a chance for the thousands of street working kids to beg for a little bit of money to survive. Unfortunately for these kids, I was dead broke. And when they asked me for $5 or $10, I just pulled faces at them and told them to try my skateboard instead. Around this time, a friend told me about a fountain that was that he'd heard about that was empty and it was perfect for skateboarding in. And I skateboarded in this fountain, and the children in the area were fascinated by what this new sport was. Some had seen skateboarding on TV, but none had really seen a real skateboard in real life. And they all really wanted to try it out. Because the boys were already riding bicycles or playing football in the park nearby, I thought it would be cool to let the girls try it out. And because skateboarding was a brand new sport, there were no societal rules that girls couldn't do it. There was a loophole. And so I gave the girls also more time to skateboard than the boys. 5 minutes for the boys, 10 minutes for the girls. And of course, because the girls had more time on the board, they became better at skateboarding than the boys. Then I ran little competitions of the boys against the girls. And of course, the girls beat the boys in every age group. This was the birth of a sport for girls, just for girls, in Afghanistan. The children taking part in these little skateboarding sessions were not all the same. Some were the street working children that were shining shoes or selling chewing gum on the street, begging in the traffic. Others lived in the middle-class apartments next to the fountain. And in Afghanistan, there's four major ethnicities, and these ethnicities don't necessarily mix with each other. But within this group of around 40 skateboarders, all ethnicities and social classes were represented. Something that happened over time was that the girls were not just better than the boys at skateboarding, they were also better at making friendships across these ethnic and class divides. One afternoon, after a really fun skateboard session, the girls all held hands, and they're all from different backgrounds, these girls. They held hands, they started to dance around the fountain and sing, and I was just amazed. I had a lump in my throat, and I was actually crying some tears of joy. It was there was these friendships that were happening through skateboarding. What was happening in the fountain was exactly what needed to happen across the whole of the country to lift it up from the ashes of war. Afghans, rich and poor and from every background, needed to hold hands and play together. And this wouldn't happen through adults. This could only happen through kids. And 50% of the population was under the age of 15. This enormous demographic had the chance to change the face of the country if only they had more chances to create more friendships across divides. And I wanted to take action. I wanted to build a skateboard school. So I knocked on doors, I wrote emails, I talked to just about anybody that would listen to me. And most people thought that I was completely naive, as well as a little bit crazy. They asked, how is a skateboard school going to work when virtually every other initiative in Afghanistan fails at one point or another? They asked, when people need food to eat, when they need shelter, when they need clean water, isn't skateboarding the very last possible priority? I was flat broke. I was thousands of kilometres away from my friends and family in Australia. And I felt ridiculed and really alone. But they all underestimated the skateboarder's advantage, persistence. We've all fallen off so many times that getting back up is second nature. They also underestimated the power and the passion of the children that were so excited to be part of this little skateboarding group, something that was so modern and something that gave them hope in their war-torn country. So with the enthusiasm of the kids and some really far-sighted donors, including a crucial land donation from the Afghan Olympic Committee, together with the governments of Canada, Norway, Denmark and Germany, we built the largest indoor sport and education facility for children in the country. And the kids from the fountain even built the skateboard ramps. The opening of Skateistan in Kabul in October 2009 was the happiest day of my life. From the polluted and dirty streets of Kabul, this movement of the youth has since grown into an international NGO that runs skateboarding and educational sessions for more than 2,000 children every week. And there are now two Skateistan skate schools in Afghanistan, one in South Africa, and one in Cambodia, where my colleague and friend Tin comes from. And so now you know how skateboarding became the largest sport for girls in Afghanistan. And now Tin will tell you a story.
Yeah, Hello, everyone. My name is Tin. I am the program officer at Skateistan in Phnom Penh, Cambodia. I have been working with Skateistan almost 6 years. And I would like to say what a pleasure it is to be here with you all today. Growing up as a girl in Cambodia was challenging, as well as poverty. Many girls, people with disabilities, face violence at home. And I used to experience violence from my dad. And I used to be afraid of everything. When I was a kid, my goal was to grow up to be a teacher at an NGO. Because I want to help street kids. I want to help them get away from violence. And there is so much inequality in Cambodia. And I want to be a part of giving children an equal start in life. But the childhood that I had, I didn't feel the best starting point for my dream. When I was 18, things began to change. I was volunteering with an NGO that was partnership with Skateistan. And when I saw children skateboarding, I thought, that is really cool, so amazing. And I wanted to try something new, so I gave it a go. I was very lucky that Skateistan asked me to come and work with them. This was a complete surprise for me. My English was not good then. I was sure that I would not. But when they called me and they told me they want to work with me, I was so excited. And to me, Skateistan was the best NGO in terms of empowering girls. And this was my dream job. And now I have become a real teacher, making a difference to children's life. This is something that I had dreamed since I was a kid. At that time, I didn't know how to skateboard. I had never been on a board before. But I had seen something that I was interested in. And I had determination that I could do it. And when I first started, I was skating with some young guys who were around 15 years old. And they were really good skaters. But they looked down on me. They looked down on me. No, I mean, because I was a girl, and because I could not do the trick like them. Sorry. So I used to cry on the way home, and I almost gave up, and I was so ashamed. But I set it as my goal. I want to change their mind. I want them to stop looking down on me. So I practice every single day. My lip bleeds, and I hurt my ankle, but I kept fighting. And until one day, I can skate better than them. And they look up to me and they call me their teacher. This makes me so proud, and I was so excited about the future hold for both them and for me. I mean, I was just an everyday girl, living in a fear and unsure what my future held. But I took my life into my own hands and I made something out of it. If the kid that I teach can see that, this could be reality too. Thank you. I have done my job.
We'll now show a quick video from the land of skate.
خوب است خیلی فایده داره ورزش ها اسکیت می کارهایی که دخترها می کنن خیلی فایده داره که کارها مهم است برای دخترها هم باید اجازه باشه که ورزش رو دخترها بکنن
خب اما کسان مهم است که استونیا جای آموختن علم است ورزش است که ما میتونیم بهتر یاد بگیریم و اسکیتستان یک جای است که بتونیم ورزش یاد بگیریم و معلومات بازه باشیم یک تغییر خاص آورده و همه قسم جرات چیز آورده که ما میتونیم اعتماد به نفس ما رو بالا ببریم و همین که ما هر طرقه یاد میگیریم
I am a citizen of Skateistan
Thank you very much.